London is very well known of how expensive it is. For instance, it's okay to spend £700 for a single room or £4 or £5 just for a coffee in Central. However, what I actually love about this city is the tons of free things that you can do. And this is why in today's video I'm going to share with you 100 free things that you can do in London. And before you get mad, I will actually show you in the video only 20, and the other 80 will be in the PDF file linked in the description down below. You can also download it and after that tick the ones you have done. Isn't that cool? And if you're new here, welcome! My name is VASI, I live in London and I love making videos about my city, but also travel. So if you want more fun and informative content like this one, don't forget to hit the subscribe button down below and also like this video because it really helps me out. And to be honest, in my opinion, one of the coolest and best things in London is the fact that all museums and galleries are free. Yes, you heard me right, you can enter free of charge and you can pretty much spend a full day in any of those. But my personal favorites are the Tate Museum, both like Tate Britain and Tate Modern, because they have a lot of contemporary art exhibitions, and also in there you can find the works of Picasso, Salvador Dalí or Andy Warhol. However, if you actually prefer more of classical art and you're not such a big fan of contemporary art, you can go to the Victoria and Albert Museum, and I swear to you, you would spend the whole day in there because you can find anything from ancient sculptures with a lot of history to fashion design or also interesting art objects. And something which I have on my list to do as soon as it opens is visit the Bank of England. Yes, you heard me right. It actually has free entry, and once you enter inside you can actually hold a genuine piece of gold, which I don't know, seems like something super fun and cool to do. You can be a real Londoner and go jogging in Hyde Park or just have a very nice and long walk around the lake. And something which you can do totally for free is watch the pelicans being fed every day around 2:30 p.m.
That's not the best video, but you get the idea.
Something else which is actually trending quite a lot on TikTok is the Kyoto Gardens, which are also known as the Japanese Gardens, and they're so colorful. They have a lot of flowers, sculptures, and also, I mean, it's quite cute from a certain angle. Yes, when you're there, it can actually look as if you're in Japan. Did you know that there are also free concerts in London? Yes, you heard me right, you can enjoy a free live performance. And one of my favorite ones is in South Bank, and they are also open at the moment. You just have to go to the website and see which is the next one available, or of course which one you enjoy. You book your ticket and there you go. Guys, actually on the PDF that you can download from below, I have listed a lot more places where you can enjoy free live performances, so make sure you download it and you check it out.
Another tip for me is that every weekend and also in other busier days, you can find amazing street performance in Covent Garden and also around Leicester Square, like this one.
Should come in for and the mountains should crumble to the sea.
And a total must for me is visiting Chinatown. Maybe you can imagine this already because I have made two videos about it. But if you come around January or February, you can go and see the Chinese New Year. Did you know that this is actually the biggest event which is organized outside of China?
And if you come in London literally any other year around this time in June, you can also join the party at the colorful Pride in London, and they have this cool parade.
Maybe you have already noticed this, but I totally love markets, because in the markets here in London you can find both pieces which are secondhand, vintage, of course there is a lot of food, but even seeing all the buzzing energy just fills me up with a lot of positive energy as well. And even seeing like some of the interesting objects which they sell in there, it's already quite an experience. And the markets, which you can visit totally for free, are
Brick Lane Market, where I suggest you going on a Sunday. You can explore the market in Camden and also after that sit next to the canal. And my personal favorite is the Portobello Road Market, which is in Notting Hill, so you can also go there, see the beautiful houses and also buy something vintage.
Another fun fact, I have actually made separate videos for any of these markets. And even if you're not a big fan of graffiti and street art, I would still really suggest you going to Bleak Street and enjoy the graffiti in there. Because in London, and I mean as I guess pretty much anywhere else, graffiti are against the law, but in this 300 meter street, which is kind of a tunnel, they actually tolerate it and it looks so cool.
Or you can have a tour and find all the blue plaques in London, which are more than 900. And the blue plaques are usually put outside of the homes of famous people. Even if they live there for a couple of months, you would still see a blue sign outside of their house.
You can get lost in Liberty, which is literally what happened to me today, even though I have been in there quite a lot of times.
And this luxury department store is very well known, not only because it was founded 146 years ago, but also because many young designers were first sold into Liberty. And not even to mention how important it was in the British Art Nouveau style.
Talking about getting lost, another place which is quite cool to get lost into is Neil's Yard, which is hidden inside colorful courtyard, and in there you can find a micro village which is full of independent restaurants, bars, cafes, shops, but even looking at these buildings and taking a quick photo is already a cool experience. Or something very very popular among tourists is to take a photo in front of one of these telephone cabins. Don't ask me why, but everyone loves them. And something else you can do for free is join the free walking tours organized by Strawberry. I will have it linked in the description down below. You guys, I literally saved you the best for last. You can go totally for free into Sky Garden and also enjoy both a beautiful London view and also these plants. It's like nature and the city are merging into this building. If you want some free views of London, you can go to Primrose Hill and admire the beautiful skyline. And if you just pick up something from the supermarket, you can also have a picnic in there, which is actually quite a popular thing to do, especially for the Londoners which live more in the northern part or close to Camden. And you guys, if you want to know what are the other 80 free things that you can do in London, don't forget to download the PDF from the description down below.
And if you enjoyed this video, don't forget to subscribe, and I will see you in this next one. Love you all! Bye!